Today we're going to talk about how to install the EZ5160 on the BigTreeTech Manta E3EZ. So I need to talk about a couple of things. This actual stepper can actually step at a higher power, meaning that you can supply a higher power to the power supply for your motors. This is the board logic power down here. And currently I'm running 24 volts. The voltage may vary for this. I'm gonna let you figure that out for the actual power. I will show you where the high power jumpers are. They're located up in here. Currently they're set for a regular power configuration. So I'm only showing you 24 volts. 48 volts, you'll have to consult the manual because I'm just showing you the general configuration. So to install the stepper, what you're going to do is you're going to look for the little bolt, turn it, and it's going to face towards you in this particular configuration. So the actual bolt is located right here for the cooling. And remember to use a cooling fan on your steppers. Now this is the X stepper, the Y stepper, the Z stepper, the E0 and E1 steppers. So extruder 1 and 2. So I'm going to plug in the actual NEMA configuration right here so that we can actually move this. Now we're also going to have to set up an end stop, and there may be an issue with this, but we'll find out in just a second. So let's go over to the desktop for a moment, and I'm on the BigTreeTech website. To find the information that you're looking for, you can type Manta, and this will bring you to the actual manual for it. So you can actually download it and then extract it right here. I've already done that, so I already don't have this open. But let me show you the other one real quick here. This is going to be the EZ type steppers. So what we have right here is the actual steppers. You can actually download this entire folder, or you can click on the particular one that you have. In this case, it would be this one. And you can pull up the manual for it. And I'll show you some stuff about the manual real quick. Obviously, they're talking about the outline of the manual here. But you can see that it can do NEMA 57 steppers. Also, it has a max power of 48 volts. I don't suggest going that high. That's why I'm doing 24. And of course, your subdivisions can be all the way up to 256th of a step. And it uses SPI or serial peripheral interface to communicate with your stepper. So I'm going to plug it in just a second. So let me take the power cord here and actually power this up for you. So I have it dangling, so let's plug it in. This is probably going to take a few moments to actually boot. And the good thing about this is that we're using the CM4. This is an 8 gigabit version. And it has EMMc built in for 8 gigs, so you don't need an actual SD card. I'm going to have to look up the actual pins for this still, so let's do that while it's booting. So I actually have the manual over here, but a quicker way to do it is to go to the pinout diagram. And as you can see right here, our X stepper is going to be PC4, and it's located right here. This may or may not fail. In my case, I've been having trouble with it. So I'll show you a workaround if that occurs. So let's go over to the computer for a second for the actual Klipper configuration. Now I had it open here and I started to configure it, but this was actually having issues. So I needed to look something up, but currently I'll show you what I did. I actually deleted this initially, and I scrolled down, and this is in printer.config. If you haven't watched my previous tutorials, you'll see where I find this. So I'm going to copy this. In other versions of Klipper, you can actually get a link to this when you paste it in, but currently that's not working. So I'm going to highlight this. And I'm actually going to do control forward slash to remove the comments. Now, we're not going to be able to use the actual diag pin in this case for sensorless homing. So we're going to use our spy pins right here, and I'll show you where those are located on the board. If you go over here, they're up in here. So these are your spy communication pins. And then there's chip select, which is right here. And that's the pin to actually say, this is the mailbox I'm communicating with in essence. But it's actually a pin in this case, but I'm trying to put it in simple terms for you. So I'll show you where that is as well. It's actually located right here for chip select. So each one of these corresponds to an access or axis, and you can see what they are. So it should be PB8. So in this case, it does say PB8. So we're good there. So let's first install the actual end stop that I was talking about before. And that's going to be right in here, and it's going to be ground and PC4. Now the board is powered. Normally I do this when it's powered down, but I want to show you what's going on. So I'm going to do a save and restart for a second here, bring it to the dashboard, and then I'll show you what I'm doing on the desktop. I'm actually taking these two wires. Red's going to be signal, black's going to be ground, and I'm going to plug it in right here. So that's all I'm doing. So let's go back over to the desktop with the camera and I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm going to check the actual end stop by typing M119 to see what the status is. It says open. So I'm going to click it, up arrow, and do the command again. Now it says triggered. So it says that it's working. So that part is set. We do have to do the configuration again. There's more to it. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to 5160. So 5160. So essentially we're using the infrastructure from the TMC to actually do the same thing. So that's all we're doing, but we need a little bit more information. There's a missing actual line here, and there's probably another one up here that I'm going to have to add, but you can see that it's set to actual spread cycle with all these nines being in here. If it was one, it would be spread cycle versus stealth chop, which this is. So if we go to Klipper, we can go to install configuration, find TMC drivers, and we're going to have to find the reference. So we're going to have to click here. And then we're going to have to find the 5160, and there's a particular value I'm looking for. So we're going to scroll down through here. I know it's moving kind of fast, but what we're looking for is just 5160 and resistor sense. So you can see that it's this line right here I'm looking for. So I'm going to copy this entire line, and I'm going to go back over to our configuration, paste it in, and then do control forward slash to remove the comment. So now that we have that set, we have the correct resistor sense. And what I mean by that is when we were back over here, if you go down a little bit further, it will actually tell you what the resistor sense is besides where we just saw it. So right here is the actual setting. So we're going to have to do that in this case for Klipper. So now that we know what that is, we're going to save this and we're going to test the access. Now there's going to be issues. So I'm going to have to use the actual end stop with my hand to stop this. And we can't do home all. So we're going to have to do G28 space X. And I'm going to put my hand on here to stop it when it actually gets to the end of an access, so I'll hit enter. And there's an error that you can see right there. It says no trigger on X after full movement. So we're gonna have to fix that. So what I'm gonna have to add into this is an actual homing underscore retract underscore dist colon zero. And I'll show you the command now. So for right here, we're gonna add this command right there. And now this should take care of the error that we just had. So I'm going to save that. And I want to point out one other thing that I forgot. If your actual configuration in Mansale OS does not work right, you can always do an update right here. Check for all updates. And when these pop red, there means they probably need to be updated. So you can click on the individual ones. So let's go back over here again. Actually, you probably didn't see what I was talking about. Let me change the actual camera here for you. It's actually covered. So over in here, I was talking about the updates for check for updates. And then each one of these would pop probably red for if it needs to be updated. So let's test this again. So I'm going to move the axis back over to the middle. I'm then going to do the G28 command. So G28 space X, put my hand by the actual end stop and do this again. And as you can see, there's no error like we had before up here. So now we can step out. So that's basically it for setting it up. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And I do need to thank my patrons as well as the people on PayPal. I'll put a thank you note at the end of the video. And also, the board was provided to me by BigTreeTech for the Manta E3EZ. The actual Raspberry Pi is my own. So everyone take care, be safe, and I'll talk to you later.